Safe by Accident, Taking the Luck Out of Safety. In this video, author Dr. Judy Agnew talks about the reactive approach that many companies take with safety. It's a matter of looking backward, using lagging indicators to determine how safely they're operating.
A lagging indicator is any measure essentially of how many people have been hurt or how severely they've been hurt. So lost time incident rate, days away with restricted duty called DART. Those are all after the fact measures of essentially accidents and incidents. The problem with lagging indicators is it tells us nothing about what people are doing to prevent accidents. It doesn't tell us if management is engaging in practices that will help prevent accidents. It doesn't tell us how many safe and at-risk behaviors are taking place at the hourly level. It just tells us how many people got hurt.
Another drawback of a reliance on lagging indicators is that they're often skewed in one direction.
When a company has a good incident rate, whether that's zero or close to zero, it gives the impression that everything's under control, that safety's just fine, thank you very much. And then what happens is people tend to focus on the other things, obviously productivity, quality, customer service. And unfortunately, we know we can go long periods of time without having an accident, despite having all kinds of at-risk conditions and unsafe behaviors. And so it really is a dangerous practice to not focus on the behaviors and to focus only on those lagging indicators, because you really have no idea how well you're doing, how good you really are. Measuring safety using these lagging indicators is the equivalent of measuring your customer satisfaction based on the number of customer complaints that you get. Now, you know, we may laugh about that, but people used to do that years, not that many years ago, that was the major measure. And we quickly realized that for every one customer that complains, there may be many more that just didn't bother calling to complain, and that for every customer that noticed some quality defect, there would be many other defects that never got noticed. And so the same is true in safety. For every one incident and accident, we know there are all kinds of unsafe conditions, at-risk behaviors, at-risk management practices behind that. So why not get on the front end of that, identify those, measure those, so we have a much better sense of how safe we actually are. If you look at what we do in quality, we have a lot of upfront leading indicators of the quality of our product, and that's what we need to do with safety. A lot of the lagging indicators are negative. They're measuring what went wrong. Unfortunately, that sets people up to then use mostly negative consequences around safety. If we want to turn that around and create an environment where people are willing to speak up and be open and honest about safety, in other words, if we want to add more positive reinforcement into the environment, we've got to start measuring what people are doing right. That then provides us something to positively reinforce.
Safe by Accident, Taking the Luck Out of Safety. For more from Dr. Judy Agnew and Aubrey Daniels, and to purchase the book Safe by Accident, visit the website safebyaccident.com.